Hey there, Cougars. Welcome back to Teaching with Technology. Today we're going to talk a little bit more about cell phones and how you can use them in useful ways in your class. One helpful tool is QR codes. QR stands for Quick Response Code, and these two-dimensional barcodes essentially help you to link to information that might be of interest to your students. To create a QR code, simply go to a QR generator website. We're going to have a couple of suggestions at the end of this presentation. There are tons of them out there that you can use. Once on the site, you just need to input the address of a site that you want the students to access when they scan the code. When the QR code is complete, you can simply put it up on a PowerPoint presentation. You can also put it on pieces of paper, anywhere you want that you want students to be able to reference. Students will need a QR app in order to access the code. And again, there's a whole bunch of free ones out there. There are lots of ways to use QR codes in your class. And today, just like Dave Letterman, we're gonna go over some of my top 10 ways you can incorporate them into your class. You can add a QR code or put it up on the screen if you want to give students an avenue to access additional information about whatever you're talking about in class. Number two, tired of your students forgetting what their homework is? Add a QR code to your presentation, and then they can scan on their way out to make sure that they have the most up-to-date information on the homework and what's coming up next in class. Number three, have problems with students forgetting your email address or your office hours or when they can contact you? Go ahead and add a QR code that links to the policies and where they might be able to get in contact with you when they're outside of class. Number four, you can use QR codes to make a scavenger hunt as well. Have them go between QR codes to access information and get clues about where to find the next one. Number five, if you teach something like art or museum studies, you can consider having QR codes up next to images, either ones that students create or ones that they're researching, in order to add more information. Instead of having written artist statements, think of having students create audio or video artist statements that you can link to using the QR code. Six, in English or literature classes, you could have students create book reviews and then incorporate the QR codes into the book so that future students or passersby can actually access the review of the book and figure out if they want to read it. Number seven, if you teach language or English as a second language, think of having QR codes on items that links to the correct pronunciation of that item. Number eight, teach in a lab. Think of using QR codes to link to safety instructions or to lab instructions that you want students to follow. Number nine, teach music. Think of adding QR codes to your music so that students can access audio versions of what a piece is supposed to sound like while they're trying to learn how to play it. Number 10, say you're teaching math and the whole class is working on problems individually. You can put the QR code up on the screen so students can access the correct answer while others are still working out the problem. So I'm sure there's a ton more ideas about how to use QR codes in classes, and I encourage you to share your comments below. But these are just a couple of my top 10. So think about incorporating a little bit more tech in your class. Until the next time, this is Ruth Gregory, Emerging Technology and Multimedia Specialist, reporting from the beautiful Palouse. Stay tech savvy. I suppose it's helpful if you have your mic on. Ah.